Well, I cannot go into details. I will just try to present the main opposition, what I am against and what I am for. I am sick and tired of this notion of revolution as kind of a carnival festivity, a big event, you know, like, remember, Syntagma Square or in Istanbul or in Cairo, this 1 million people gather, we are all ecstatic and so on. This means nothing to me. I think that a real revolution happens the day after, or the morning after, as they say, after you awaken from being drunk. The real revolution, and it's very difficult to achieve, is after all these upheavals, ecstatic elements, when life returns to normal, everyday life, how do ordinary people feel the change? And I will mention it today in my talk, I like this example. I hope many of you saw that film, which was popular with some leftists, V for Vendetta. And my enigma with that film was always this one. You remember, at the end, the people penetrate through the police blockade, they occupy the British Parliament, people took power. And then, the end of the film. My God, I would sell my mother into slavery to see a film, V for Vendetta, part two. But what do they do then? When once the good guys win, let us say. Don't we have here maybe the greatest tragedy of the 20th century? You remember what happened with Syriza. They won the referendum. Next day they made the compromise. And I don't blame them in the sense of traitors and so on. They saw that they really cannot do anything. So again, I hate this idea of revolution, you know. Things are stable, boring, and every couple of years we need some big event, enthusiastic, ecstasy and so on. I don't care about that. The most important aspect or the revolutionary process is for me change in daily, everyday, daily life. And here, although it wasn't a real revolution, I even have a certain sympathy for 68 movement in France and Europe. Okay, it failed as a social revolution. But listen, many things nonetheless passed into the daily life. Just think about what we have now, like you have it in Madrid, in all big cities, Pride parades, gay parades, and all that. Or the different way we treat women. Are we aware that as an effect of 68, we are not allowed, at least publicly, we are all maybe male chauvinists privately, but publicly, we are not allowed to talk in a certain vulgar way about women. It's not so much that it's prohibited. You appear as an idiot if you do. So you see, this is, I think, especially important today. Because remember, Occupy Wall Street. Okay, big thing, but then it disappeared. And we will see what will happen out of it. Just my idea is, forget about this 19th century, even more than 20th century metaphor, you know, revolution, thousands on the street, barricades. That's relatively easy to do. The problem is what happens afterwards. And that was probably also the tragedy of the October Revolution. Lenin once wrote it. You know when was the real difficulty and failure? After Bolsheviks won the Civil War, and then 1920, they won, and they had this truly difficult, tremendous task. Now we have power. How will we reorganize daily life? There they failed, really. That's why Stalin entered. So again, this is what I will be pleading for with my talk today, with that strange title, A Plea for Bureaucratic Socialism. I mean, these small regulations of daily life, this matters to ordinary people. That should be revolution.